I'm Amanda from Adventures in FitNyx. I've got another video review for you today on another home fitness product. Today we're looking at the Pink Win Athletics Stability Ball. I have it in pink because, of course, pink. Why would you get any other color? This is a small ball. This is about 65 inches around. I was able to measure it with the included measuring tape. They actually included it with instructions saying to inflate to 81 inches. There's no way this ball is going to inflate to 81 inches. It is 65 and it's barely that. And it is about as small as I can get it without worrying that it'll pop while I'm using it. So I guess that's the first big negative here of the Pink Win ball is that it does not inflate as big as advertised. But it does inflate. 65 is not too small. It's actually a pretty standard size, so it's very usable at this circumference. I was able to inflate it with the included pump, so they do have a little foot pump that it comes with a hose and a nozzle. You can inflate it. You can also switch it to the other side and deflate the ball if you need to. It's overinflated, so you can use the pump for that, or you can just pull out the pin, the air comes right back out. They actually do include an extra pin to, if you lose your first pin, you have a second one here. They also have a pin remover, so if you've got the ball fully inflated and you need to get the pin out, you're able to use this little tool to work in there, save your fingernails. Nice little addition. So they do give you a complete kit. They do have everything you need to inflate, deflate, measure, whatever you need to take care of it. They also include a little exercise guide. It's got pictures and descriptions. I've seen the back here. I'll show you there. You can see it's got some descriptions and pictures of how to do different exercises, which is handy if you've never used the ball before. Some of the highlights of actually using the ball is that it's very durable feeling. I don't feel like this is too thin of rubber. I don't think it's going to break while I'm using it as long as I don't overinflate it. I think that it's got a good shape. It's not lopsided. I do still have some creases in my ball from when I opened it, so everything being packaged in this little box, which is a nice little package. But it doesn't mean that the ball is deflated when you get it and smushed in with plastic shrink wrap. So when you take it out, I might have loved to find it shrink it out a little bit more, or if I were to overinflate it at first, you know, push out some of the creases. It's probably hard to see unless you're right up in front of it. There's some creases you can see there in the lighting on the ball. Obviously, there are some ridges that are meant to be there, but there's also the creasing and the move around that you can see there. But there's still some kinks in the ball to work out. But other than that, it's in good shape. I think these will come out in time. And they're certainly not something that's going to interrupt the way that you actually use the ball. So, pretty good size, pretty good shape. Definitely usable for any exercises. For example, some of the exercises in our life include piping, which is a difficult one. You get on the ball, you're going to pull the ball way up, and then slowly go back out. This is a top challenge move that uses the instability of the ball to challenge more than just the muscles that are pulling the ball up. It's challenging the whole stability. In fact, you can pull yourself up a little further and augment some of your normal workout routine doing push-ups with the feet on the ball or the shin on the ball. That's actually going to add instability to your workout, which will again activate more of your core. So it's pretty cool that you can use it both for unique exercises like the pipe, which don't be very difficult to perform without the ball, or other exercises like push-ups. Which can be augmented with this. You can do other all kinds of different exercises you can do. You can do leg work, you can pull it up and do curls like this, or carrying it back here, or in the floor. Again, it's instability, it's challenging your body. You can actually sit on the ball. This is you can do things like sit-ups. This gives you keep it stable. This gives you a little extra range, so when you're going back, you can actually go past neutral, allowing you to add an additional element there for your sit-ups. You can use it as a prop. You can hold it, you can hold it up, you can move it to the side and side. You can do squats doing that, you can do lunges. Pretty much any kind of exercise where your arms are not already engaged. Holding that ball, squeezing it a little bit, will activate the arms, add diversity to that workout, challenge your whole body to any move to a little bit higher level of challenge. So it's definitely a very versatile piece of equipment. Legs, core, arms. You can probably put some cardio on it and sat and bounce on it. And in fact, sitting on the ball is another thing that a lot of people do. This is probably too small of a ball for me to use this at my office. My desk is a little higher. But if you had a bigger ball, you could sit on the ball during the day and rock back and forth and just keep your body moving so that your core has to engage throughout the day instead of just sitting in a chair where you can lean back and your body doesn't have to move itself up. I've never actually done something like that as a replacement for my office chair. But I do know a lot of people really enjoy that. And as long as you're not punching yourself trying to stand the ball, you can probably actually get a lot of benefit just by keeping your whole body moving. Every little change, every dynamic motion activates more of your core. So there are those extra benefits to the ball. The only big downside to this ball is if you want to store it, if you don't have much space, you want to store it, you have to pull the pin and inflate it, which means you've got to pump it up in. It took me 6 minutes to inflate the ball to this size. It's not that long, but you wouldn't want to be doing inflation and deflation every day if you want to use this as a regular workout routine. So you do have to consider the space it's going to take to store it, or consider the time it's going to take to deflate and put back in the box. Other than that, pretty good piece of equipment. Like I said, versatile, which is very important if you're going to invest in a home gym, especially if you've got limited space. You don't want to be putting money into a ball like this that's going to take up space if it's only good for one exercise. This ball can be adapted to a whole bunch of different things. In their exercise packet, they actually can do 12 different exercises. That's already a lot, and it is a full body workout, including things like planking on the ball, your elbows on the ball, more instability, ball sits and squats, things like that, using the ball as a little bit extra buffer between your back and the ball so that when you're rolling down, it's making it more the instability from side to side, again, challenging more and more. So there's lots of different things you can do with this, making it a really good investment for your home gym. That is all I have to say about the Peak Win Athletics protocol right now. I will bring you up on my blog as well. The link is going to be down in the comments underneath this video. You can also follow me on Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, all kinds of things like that. I will be posting workouts and little moves with all the different equipment that I am trying. So you can get an idea of more ways to use the piece of equipment than what I just showed here. So do check in the social media, do check the blog, and check out Peak Win Athletics. They gave me more than just the ball. In fact, in a couple days, I have a phone order from them that I'll be reviewing. But they also make a few other products. So check them out, links down there in the comments. And looking for the ball. It's a good one to get. Thank you so much for your time. I'll see you next time.